I go to scrapyards. I've been going to scrapyards for about 40 years and had the pleasure and honor of studying with some other really neat and nice and good found object sculptors. So this piece, is this that composite of different found objects? And as an artist, you get to not only build them, but you get to name them. And a lot of the names, when I'm actually talking to a group of kids, a lot of kids come up with a lot better names than I had on them. So it's very creative to try and name a piece like that. And I did a daydreaming series. So this is, I guess, the first piece we can talk about it. Got any questions about it? When you build art like this, besides the creative side, you got to make sure you can move it, and it's stable, and it's safe. So just for a hint, when we go around to all my other large outdoor pieces, feel free to touch them. And when I was installing here on campus, it was really kind of fun because I was installing on campus and I was with a bunch of students. And I said, you can touch the big pieces and you can, you know, you won't get hurt. This girl, a student, I guess she was a freshman, said, do you mind if I climb it? I said, okay. And I mean, she must have been a tree climber. She just got to the top in 2 or 3 seconds of this big piece outside. And we videoed that. It was kind of fun. So why I say that, on art like this, if you touch it, I got to make sure you're not going to get little pieces of metal in you. So I touch every piece just to make sure, because I know kids are going to come up and grab them. So why don't we go outside if we're ready and do a walk.